You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, special edition from Microsoft Ignite, where we learn how cognitive services put together make for amazing intelligent applications with my friend here, Chris. We'll see you there. Hello and welcome to the special edition of the AI Show, coming to you from Microsoft Ignite, where we're going to learn about a bunch of cognitive services from Chris. Tell us who you are and what you do, my friend.
Yeah, I'm Chris Hoder. I'm a program manager on the cognitive services team, and today I want to show you a little bit about how the cognitive services are letting businesses get more productive and embed intelligence into their applications.
And you're going to show us like a not just one, but a couple where we're solving problems with a bunch of them. Is that right?
Yeah. So I want to show how you can start with some base technology like our OCR, which can extract text from images,
okay,
and then use that to build a higher and higher level capabilities.
So, all right, let's do it.
Yeah, so first I want to show you that base OCR capability. So okay. This year we released a new update to that model, which really improved the performance.
And this app that you're showing us, where is this coming from?
Yeah, so this app is a demo application that we've built and we put out there in open source. You can find it in GitHub under Intelligent Kiosk.
All right, we'll make sure to put a link in the show notes so you can go and look at that.
Yeah, definitely. And so I want to start by just showing kind of what's available out of the box. You just send an image to our cloud service and it can go and detect the text right out of the image without you having to build your model, train it, and do any of that complexity.
And that's cool because it's not just, it's crooked. I mean, it's not even straight, and it still somehow got that, right?
Yeah, it's getting it crooked, it's getting the different sizes, and you get the bounding boxes so you know where it is. And so this is what you get out of the box with just our OCR capability.
Okay.
And then what we've released, starting at build and continuing to build and mature, is our form recognizer product.
Which is really cool. I'm a huge fan of this thing.
So form recognizer lets you build on that base OCR and not just get, you know, a bunch of words in a digital format, but start to know, hey, I've extracted this word and I know that it is the address in the address field of my form.
I see, okay.
And so I got a quick demo to show that here.
Let's see it.
Where we can look at invoices, where you might have this invoice from your business, where you have some fields, but you might not just want to know the address, but you want to know that it is an address and you want to know what is the invoice number.
I see.
So all you need to do with the form recognizer is provide at least 5 examples of your filled out form. We'll go ahead and train the model for you, customize it to your specific form, and then you can just send an image and get the content back.
Now, while this is loading, one of the cool things is I actually did this demo, and I foolishly thought I need to give it as many PDFs, and they're like, no, Seth, you need to give it just 5 and it will be able to recognize it.
Yeah.
All right, so what is it that it actually returns? Because I love form recognizer, like I was saying, but what does it actually return?
Yeah, so what you get back is not just the extracted text, but you get it back in JSON, already extracting in a key value pair scenario. So let's take a look. So looking at the raw data that's sent back, you can see that we get the key is an address.
Okay.
And the value here is one Redmond Way.
That's right? Cool.
So it's not just that we know, hey, one Redmond Way is on this form. We know that is the address that's being listed here. And so it really lets you kind of get to more powerful scenarios faster than just that root base OCR engine that we showed earlier.
That's awesome. So we did OCR, which was amazing. We did form recognizer. What else you got?
Yeah, so now I want to show you how you can take this capability and build it in and combine with some of our other cognitive services to continue to get even more powerful solutions.
Awesome. So, let's see that.
Yeah, so I have a quick scenario here called insurance claim automation.
All right, let's take a look at that.
So you can imagine we're insurance adjusters.
Okay, you and me.
Somebody's sending us a picture of their car that they had a windshield accident.
Okay.
And so we asked them to take a picture, and maybe they submit a form of their incident.
That's an awesome incident you got going on over there.
Yeah, and so you can see here that, you know, they might submit both of these,
mm-hmm.
and we can then use custom vision, which allows you to train a custom object detection to basically identify the windshield crack in the
That's amazing. Like, so you uploaded an image, and it's basically, you get the crack, you know where it is, and you're able to submit this and get some automation automatically.
Yeah.
Automation automatically. That's what AI is all about, my friends.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And so you can see what's returned here is we're getting this custom vision's detecting the crack, mm-hmm. telling us that it's there, and then it's using form recognizer to extract the claim details from the form we uploaded, combining it together, and now you can automate that pipeline and really speed up the process of getting, you know, the money back in the hands of the person that needs it.
And the thing that's cool about this is sometimes when I look at cognitive services, I'm like, oh, well, that's useful. But it's even more powerful when you start to put them together into actual applications. Are customers seeing success doing this?
Yeah, we're seeing tons of customers pick it up, combine them, and we're really seeing that kind of combining multiple services leads to a solution that's way more powerful than any one of them could combine.
Well, thank you so much, Rashad. Yeah, this is really cool. Again, where can people get this demo?
Yeah, so this demo is available on GitHub under the Intelligent Kiosk name.
All right, we'll make sure to put the link below. Thank you so much. This was awesome, because the thing about cognitive services, it's kind of weird when you look at each one of them and you're like, oh, these are gonna be, but when you put them together, they make for really amazing applications. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for watching this special edition of the AI Show, coming to you from Microsoft Ignite, where we learned how a bunch of cognitive services together made intelligent applications even more amazing. Again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.